Hello there, this is LT from LT's Trains, and today I'd like to start a session on photographing your model railroad and also videotaping your model railroad. And I would like to share with you some of the pitfalls that I have come across over the years, and also to share with you the type of equipment that I'm using to photograph my model railroad. And we will also look at such things as the construction of the layout and what impediments that created that I did not even think of. So I will share my mistakes with you, and hopefully these will help you in determining how you build your layout and also how you will photograph your layout in the future. Thank you for watching. Alrighty, so let's talk about the railroad room and the construction thereof, first of all. So there was a few pitfalls that I have run into, and I didn't consider some of them, and others I knew about or are aware of, but physically it was out of my control. And one of those is, if you look up at the ceiling, you can see these par cans up there. They're recessed, which is okay. They put out a good spread of light, but problem is they're too far out in the middle of the room. I told the guys to put them a foot and a half away from the wall. Well, they're 2 foot out. So hence the light from the par cans don't land on the layout itself. It's too far away. And if we look over here, you can see the layout over there on the right hand side is basically a self shelf layout, and the park hand's sitting out there 2.5 feet away from the layout. Okay, so that was the first mistake, and unfortunately I was working when they put these in, so I got vetoed out as far as having them replaced. They were all wired and set in and ready to go for sheetrocking. Okay, so that was one heartburn. The next is I have a two-level layout, two tiers, and so that creates lighting problems in itself. The lower level has to be lighted somehow or it gets extremely dark. And so I did that, and I was trying to be cheap about the whole thing, so I put in, and we'll take a look under here. There, you can see it now on the top of the camera. So I put on these outdoor tube lighting LEDs. You know, they're warm white. And that works. I bought it at Costco. But it's not perfect. And it created problems when you've got a DSLR camera and it's got a 3.5 lens on it or a 4.5 lens on it. You don't have enough light. So then you have to have extra light panels to light up what you're photographing. Also up above here, I put in some LED lighting. You know, that started to come out on the market, but this is actually too blue, and I'm probably going to replace this with something else. We'll see. Shoots pretty good on the I'm using what right now is called a Hero 8 action camera, which is allowing me to do a lot more than I can with the DSLR, but we'll talk about the cameras later on. I just want to talk about the layout room. So keep in mind, if you want to do photography, you may not want to have a second level because it makes it difficult to photograph the lower level. If you're using conventional type camcorders or a DSLR with video capabilities, keep that in mind, because you've got the weight of the camera and you've got to get in there and manipulate what's going on. Okay, so those were a couple of pitfalls that I didn't consider, and kind of have to sort of live with it, you know, once you got the layout built. So you do the best you can. Okay, so that pretty much takes care of the room itself. I'm just doing a pan here so you can see what the lighting's like. Oh, and on this side, I've got no way to put lighting over the second level because I don't have any shelving up here to hook it to. I'd have to come out with something on brackets and then hang it over the layout. So consequently, this side of the room is upper level is rather dark, as you can see here in the photograph. And again, that creates lighting problems. Again, you have to have a camera that's got at least a 2.8 lens on it, or a 1.5 or a 1.4, so you can get all the light that you can in on your exposures. You can see right here how it's a lot brighter. Okay, because there's a parkan up here that's taking care of that. But when we go over here, it gets quite dark. So to supplement that, I'm going to have to use a light panel attached to the Hero or my DSLR to compensate for the lighting. So these things are items that have created some heartburn for me, and I'm hopefully that what I'm presenting here for you will help you in making your decisions for building your layout room, and help you have more fun with your model railroading. Okay, so that's pretty much it for now as far as the layout room goes. I can't think of anything else that gave me trouble. Other than that, the height here is at 52 inches, 50 or 52 inches from the floor. Well, I'm only like 5'7", so it puts the second level for me at about my shoulder. And so it's difficult to operate when you're up that high. But for me, I didn't have any option because I've got a lot of cabinets and stuff, as you can see, on both sides of the room. I needed the room for storage. And I need the desktop area for my workbench. And so I had to go with that height. I couldn't drop down the first level any lower than what it is. Okay, so these are all things to consider as far as a layout room goes. Another thing is your heating. Make sure that you get proper heat, if at all possible. Trains don't like to run in a damp area, and it's hard on the track, and it's also hard on the expansion and contraction of the layout itself. Okay, so just one little caveat here. It just hit me after I turned off the power. I don't think if I were to do this again, I would go a second level. Probably for some of the reasons I had mentioned. One is the height. And it's a difficult height to deal with when you're photographing the layout. The other one is operations. You know, it's not too difficult, but I think it would have been a lot easier if it all been down at the 46-inch level. And the idea would have been better to have come into the center of the room, which I'll show here. Let me get turned around. Sorry for the jiggling. But so I think it would have come in down here at the far end and brought it down the center, down in through here, and brought it down this way, where I've got all my airbrushing equipment right now in the center of the room, and built a mushroom layout. So, you know, keep that kind of stuff in mind. You know, come up with several designs before you start building. If you can talk to a model railroader or a group, I'm certain they will share their ideas with you on what type of operations and construction you should do for your model railroad. Okay, so there was one other thing I forgot to mention, and that's the lighting itself. Try to keep all your temperature of your lighting, the color temperature of your light, the same. I got a real mishmash in here. I've got the ceiling lights. They're running a little bit above 3,400. And then I've got under the balance or under the second level here, for the first level, I've got, in this case, a real mishmash. I've got, as you can see, I've got both LED strip lighting and also these tube lights, which are a warm white running about 3,400, and the LEDs are running around 5,500. So I got a real mishmash on my hands here. Visually, it looks pretty good, but when you use the camera out, it kind of looks a little blue. It's not too bad. So I need to redo that. And then up above, I got nothing. You know, I've got all these dark and light areas going on. So I could have fixed this by putting in a balance. But the choice I made here was to have my photos and prints and whatnot, railroad prints, hanging on the wall. And that was more important to me than putting in a balance. On top of that, a balance is a lot of work. I wanted to get running trains instead of building stuff into the ceiling. And then on the other side, lighting over here is different. And again, it needs to be changed. I've got the 5,500 up here. And I think it's a little bit more than that. And so it gives kind of a blue cast to it, which I don't like. And then down below, again, I've got the Costco ribbon lights running at 3,400. So I got two different temperatures. Got one running hot and one running cold. So no consistency here. Big faux pas on my part. So ribbon lighting, these LED strip lights now, you know, it didn't come on the market until after I started building the layout and pretty much had everything in. So it's been an afterthought for me, but it's easy to replace and it's pretty inexpensive. So just keep that in mind. Try to keep your lighting consistent, keep the color temperature consistent, and you'll be a lot happier with your layout, especially when it comes to photographing.